2002.
Well, Detroit may be the largest city in American history to go bankrupt, but it's not alone. And as dozens of other cities fight for fiscal survival, crucial infrastructure upgrades are being pushed to the side.
Caitlin Burke reports on a way those cities on the brink can not only generate substantial revenue, but also get the upgrades they so desperately need.
Across the country, more and more cities struggle to pay their bills. Obligations from payroll to health care to pension funds squeeze already shrinking budgets.
But there is a solution, a way to make those desperately needed infrastructure updates without using government money. It's called public-private partnerships.
Critical infrastructure projects often get sidelined. The result? Crumbling highways, outdated water systems, and electric grids that can't keep up.
Under a partnership, private sector will come and do the investment, so it's not on the books of the public sector. It's a private sector debt.
Richard Norman says these partnerships can improve the quality of a wide range of services.
We use partnerships for transportation, that's an obvious one. But for energy systems, water systems, real estate and economic development, housing, hospitals, schools, I mean, it's almost endless supply.
Poor maintenance contributes to that growing need, and new building projects rarely make it to a city's drawing board. Private investors can replace that aging infrastructure and provide state-of-the-art services. There's a big need in New York City. Engineer Mitch Simpler calls the Big Apple's electrical infrastructure insufficient.
Con Ed has the same issue that the rest of the utilities have, which is, you know, they had never envisioned the kind of electrical growth that the city has experienced. And the good news is the city is growing. We are building more buildings, all of whom need a significant amount of power. And Con Ed is doing their very best to deliver it. But it's a finite resource, and their infrastructure has finite capabilities. Because of all that, their utility rates are extraordinary. And it's, again, because of the rates that they have to charge to cover this infrastructure upgrade, not making it more reliable, more robust, simply to be able to keep pace with the increasing demand.
Former New York Governor George Pataki says the stage is set for private investors to step in with financially effective solutions.
What I hope we do far more of in New York and in the country going forward is empower private companies with tremendous expertise, and not just the expertise, but also billions of dollars that they want to invest in infrastructure projects to work with the public sector to come up with both financially better, more effective, and quicker solutions to the infrastructure problem.
The need exists, and the private funding is there. Now it's up to state and local leaders to get on board and take advantage of the opportunity. Caitlin Burke, CBN News, Washington.